people. What would you tell us about improving literacy rates in Uganda, especially among women?
We want to see Uganda really become what it was destined to be. And we know that education can play a major role to do that. And so this government is offering a universal education both at primary and secondary level so that all our children of school going age can get education. But we also do literacy education at the village level for adults, for women and men who want to learn to read and write, so that we can get our country really to be literate. And we do that deliberately, because we believe that this is something we should have achieved a long time ago. We didn't because we had challenges in our society, but now is the time.
Do you think that Uganda is more ready now for investment and development after improving literacy rates?
Yes, of course, I think that. I believe that because this country has security of human life and property, and it has a literate population, we can very easily attract investment, and we really go out deliberately to attract foreign and regional investment, because we need that. And it's also good for our region and for those people who come from elsewhere to come and invest in Uganda. There are many opportunities here yet to be explored, and we want to see that happen.
So what are the business and investment opportunities in Uganda? And please let me inform you that we love shea butter from Uganda. Really, we do.
I am pleased to hear that.
And but moringa oil too.
That's good.
Yeah, so what are the business opportunities and investment opportunities in Uganda from your point of view?
There are so many opportunities. We have so many resources that we have been exporting raw. Now we want them processed in the country so that we don't have to export coffee in its raw form, or cotton, or tea, or gold, or silver, or so much. So we want all that processed in the country so that our people can be able to access their own materials that are made in Uganda. And we invite people who have those skills to come and do it here with us.
So is this the next step that you're working on, that everything should be made in Uganda?
This is what we're actually doing right now. Mm. It's not the next one, it is actually happening right now. You talk about the abattoir.
Yes, yeah.
It is in part of what we are doing.